beyond the conversation of the logo. I want to address a matter that the speaker raised very well here. He talked about this group of young people who seem to be coming together for whatever purposes, even whatever political formation, assuming that they may be supporting a candidate, though they say they don't. The comments that were made here about where they come from, I don't know, they are from Runda, they are from Othaiga, they are well-to-do, they are not from Kibra. I just thought that when you think about the formation that he somehow seems to support, which is the one they call the Hustler Movement. Now, my colleague Opia Wandai is right about the actual English definition of a hustler. But I know that in slang is also a person who seems to be struggling, coming up and maybe doing, you know, struggling to make ends meet. But look at the leadership of that Hustler Movement. From the top is a deputy president. Is he really one of those you'd call a hustler? The chair, my former senator, you know, Johnston Nduya Muthama, is he really one of those that you'd call a hustler? You know, for whatever purposes, I think, if you're talking about honesty, if you're talking about hustlers, those mamambogas, they are not represented even in that party. So this is politics. And now the issue of lobby groups, the purpose of lobby groups is to target that group. For example, when you're doing a lobby group for women, it is so that those women in your party speak to other women. When you have a youth lobby group like YK92, it is for the youth to speak to the other youth about their intentions and how your party can help them. And that is why, because you know, right now, the biggest population of voters is actually the youth. And that is why I think the youth are being targeted. That's why these groups will come and form around the youth. I think it's a tragedy that we have so many unemployed youth. And that is why even a meeting of a few, we are quickly looking at the kind of dressing mode, because we know a lot of our youth are out there in the villages suffering. I think it's a tragedy. So many years after independence, we still have such a huge population of young people that are still struggling out there. And I think for going forward, as we are looking at the next election, let us look beyond ourselves as leaders who are looking for political office and look at the plight of these young women, men and women, because that's really a problem. And you know what? My biggest fear going forward, and that is to do with the youth and these youth lobby groups. You see, now when they start coming together, it means they're waking up. What will happen if you give them huge promises like we are hearing on the campaign trail, and then 2 years down the road, you cannot meet any of the promises? You know, that is really the recipe for a disaster and for a revolution. So it's important that as we use the youth now, as we use them as in our lobby groups, as we talk to them, as we seek their vote, let us be careful that we do not, you know, incite them without knowing against ourselves. And finally, Wahiga, you know, I thought when I listened to C.S. Matiang'i, and sorry to go back there, on the issue of the youth and the violence, I think there is also something else we need to condemn. There is also, not only are there people who go to violently disrupt rallies, but there are also people who go there to disrupt by heckling. I think even that is also, you know, it's causing a scene and it's also unlawful. So we also need to condemn those youth that are also ferried to other people's rallies to go stand there and start shouting the name of a candidate who is not on the podium, who is not in the meeting, who is an opponent, because it doesn't help at all.